Hello, wonderful peoples. How are you doing? I know it's been a while, but looks like this CV pandemic has got me back on YouTube. So, welcome back to everyone who has not been here for a while. I'm so sorry I've been MIA, but been busy. There's so much to talk about, but just never had the time. But luckily, we're now in a lockdown, so plenty of time, eh? We are on day number 28 of the lockdown right here in Rwanda. And I've been thinking about recording a video for a while, but you know, never really got around to it, and I never thought that we'll make it this far into the lockdown actually. But yeah, so it is happening. We have several cases now, over 100 in Rwanda. These are the current numbers as of the day of this recording, or maybe of this editing of the video, which is still quite modest in comparison to other countries around the world, but hey, it is what it is. In this video, I just want to give you a little bit of a corona update right here in Rwanda, and also go back into history, into like the first week when after we got our first case, because that's when most of this action happened, and take it from there on. First of all, I would like to thank you all. I woke up like 2 days ago checking my YouTube channel, and I realized that there are like 15,000 subscribers. I'm like, thank you. Cheers to many more. Anyway, so here is a little bit of the CV update here in Rwanda. Rwanda was hit with the first corona case on Friday the 13th of March. Remember that. A Indian man who traveled from India just checked himself in, and it was announced to the public like the day after, on Saturday the 14th. On that same day, things started to move pretty quickly. The government announced that all places of worship will be closed from there on. Schools will be closing starting on Monday. Large gatherings and sports events were postponed until further notice. Most of this news here in Rwanda travels through WhatsApp. So after, you know, patient zero was announced, someone found it to be like a good idea to circulate some kind of an ID of an Indian man. But it turned out to be a random Indian man who did not contract the CV, the coronavirus, but it was bad, man. It was bad. But luckily, even the Minister of Health, you know, made like an official statement on Twitter saying that this was the wrongful person. So I'm glad that got rectified. So after that, we got like regular updates of new cases that were coming in Rwanda. On Sunday, we got 4 new cases. On Monday, we got 2 new cases, and that's also when at the gym we decided to halt all group classes. Just in anticipation of, you know, this virus moving around, and we did not want to have it, you know, spread at our gym. On Tuesday, we got no new cases, but the government announced that people are not allowed to go on the motorcycle with the windshield on. Apparently, that was like a danger for spreading the virus. So that means no windshield. And the funny thing was, after they announced that, I don't know how that happened, but the following day, all motorcycles had removed the windshield. I was really amazed on how fast this communication moved around, because yeah, like the official statement was also not that big, but everyone knew the following day. So kudos. That also meant like riding a motorcycle with tears or just looking down. Luckily, I got to revamp my old sunglasses, you know, that I still had laying around, because without them, you know, riding a motorcycle would have been painful. On Wednesday, we got 4 new cases, which made a total of 11. On Thursday, no new cases, stayed at 11. On Friday, we got 6 new cases, and from that day on, all commercial flights were banned. And they also issued a statement that saying bars are only allowed to open until 9 p.m. and 7 p.m. in the rural areas. I think they just did it because it was the weekend, that they were like expecting lots of people to go out and, you know, party for one last time. But the following day, things moved fast. On Saturday the 24th of March, with 17 cases in total, the government announced at 7 p.m. that there was going to be a lockdown starting from 12 a.m. So that means you only had like 5 hours left of freedom of movement. So it was a good and a bad thing that it came so quickly, because well, there was little time to panic, because, well, yeah, Saturday, 7 p.m., you're either out or you're in, and you're not going to make any crazy, drastic decisions. But on the other hand, people are just getting worried, like, how are we going to do groceries? How are we going to be, you know, do our thing? But it turned out to be okay, in a way. So starting on Sunday, I would say that was like the first day of the lockdown, and we've been in lockdown ever since for now 28 days and counting. And yesterday they announced that it has been prolonged for another 10 days or so. So yeah, we are stuck in here. So what makes this lockdown also really particularly unique is that it is happening during the commemoration month of the genocide that happened here in Rwanda in 1994. For me, I don't have a television here, and I follow most of the news just on Twitter and on, you know, on WhatsApp. So I'm not really up to date into what is happening from the, you know, official government statements. But it is kind of quiet, and people have been asked to stay inside as much as possible. And the funny thing is, people are really doing it. The roads are quite empty, not fully empty. There are still cars and people walking around, but it's drastically lessened, the amount of people on the street. And yeah, so maybe in a future video I can tell you more about it. But for now, I just want to give you a quick update on how things are going here in Rwanda. And so if you like these videos, give it a big thumbs up, guys. I'm gonna be trying to make more videos. Like I said, life without Wi-Fi makes a YouTube life very, very hard. But anyway, I'm gonna make it work anyway. Guys, stay safe wherever you are. Just comment in the comment section below in which country you are, and you know, and how long you are in your lockdown, if you are in the lockdown anyway. All right, thank you very much for watching, guys. I would like to see you all in the next video. Mwalamukia.